Here's my audience. Okay, so you're all men in the audience, so this speech will pertain to you. So imagine this. You and your wife are having a baby, and you're super excited about it, and it's your first child. The time finally comes when your baby is born, and you're super excited because you cannot wait to spend as much time as possible with this child. However, while your wife is on paid maternity leave, you have to work and make a steady income for your family. And this is a problem because you're really worried about bonding with the child and not being in the picture as often as the wife is. In a way, this is kind of an issue of inequality, and it's kind of sexist in a way. How is this hurting the world? This only benefits three people: the father, the mother, and the newborn child. It also creates healthier families, which is what the world needs more of. Every workplace should offer paid paternity leave, and paid paternity leave will help break gender barriers and create healthier families. So throughout the entirety of my speech, I will discuss two problems, two causes, and two solutions to this issue. Not having paid paternity leave is a pressing issue in the United States. However, this is due to two problems: dated American ideals and the amount of wages replaced during leave. In a Business Insider article written by Rachel Vallette in 2017, she talks about how cultural values surround paid paternity leave. About 80% of Americans say that paid paternity leave is necessary, so why don't we have it yet? Well, Rebecca Ray and Janet Gordick assess gender equality in their journal, Slow and Work and Family Research Network, written in 2009. They talk about how parenting is really feminine and there's social constructs that surround it. Well, in a New York Times article written by Claire Pan Miller in 2014, this is a direct quote. She states, "When men start diverging from the breadwinner role by taking time off and having fewer hours, they're penalized. Why should fathers be penalized for wanting to be a father?" In the United States, we do have time off. However, it is unpaid. This can lead to impoverishment and leading the dad to choose whether they want to spend time with their child or whether they want to work. This only benefits wealthier families in the end, because if they have the money, then they don't necessarily need to work. And it does not benefit the middle class or lower class, and this can transmit from generation to generation. There's also a difference in gender roles and how much the female and male gets paid. So with dated American ideals and the amount of wages replaced during leave, we can assess the causes of masculinity and the FMLA, which is the Family and Medical Leave Act. In Paradoxes of Gender, written by Judith Lorber in 1994, she helped me understand the causes of masculinity and gender roles in parenting. So women are naturally more nurturing. They're naturally more loving and caring for other people. Not saying that men aren't, because they are, but they're also emotionally invested in women, like their siblings, or sisters, their wives, their mothers, etc. And this is where masculinity comes into play. Gender parenting defines inferiority. The U.S. Department of Labor, which was revised in 2012, talks about the Family and Medical Leave Act. The Family and Medical Leave Act is a 12-week unpaid leave, which is very rare for men. It's more common for women. Basically, the employee has to follow normal rules and substitute paid leave. Employees are eligible if they've worked at least 12 months, if they've worked at least 1,250 hours in those 12 months, and if the company has employed more than 50 people. The employers must provide benefits during this unpaid leave time. So there's two solutions to this problem. One is to fulfill whatever role you want to fulfill in society and in the media. Allison Lantang writes in her blog, Gender Roles in Media, which was written in 2014, that we choose to accept or deny what we hear and see in the media. Did you know that the rate of stay-at-home dads is rapidly growing in the nation? The American Psychological Association estimated that about 159,000 out of 64 million dads in the nation are becoming stay-at-home dads. If more people could see this information, then I can guarantee you that more dads would advocate for paid paternity leave. The second solution is to just take action. Write to your local legislators and explain why you think paid paternity leave is necessary for new and upcoming dads in the nation. We need to convince the the government and people of America that paid paternity leave should be offered at every workplace. Men fearing femininity and losing income needs to stop, and we also need to revise the Family and Medical Leave Act. Choosing between wanting to spend time with your child and wanting to work is kind of messed up. Why not have the best of both worlds? Thank you. Here's my audience.